This video is about individual parameters, how they are defined, estimated, and where they are used in monoliths. The first task in monoliths estimates the population parameters, which characterize the population. But often, we would also like to get the parameter values for each individual present in the dataset. In the population approach, we assume that individual parameters come from a probability distribution P, which describes the variability of the parameters between individuals in the population. Monoliths by default uses a transformation, denoted here by H, of individual parameters psi. It gives a clear decomposition of individual values around a population value psi pop, with part of the variability explained by covariates with parameters beta, and part of the variability unexplained and represented by normally distributed random effects eta I. The individual model in monoliths is defined in the interface in the statistical model and task tab, where it is possible to customize the distribution type using one of the four options and to add and remove random effects, covariates, and their transformations. Previous features of the big videos already explain how to define and customize the individual model. For example, feature of the week number 31 presents different distributions types available in monoliths. Feature of the week number 33 and 63 show how to customize them. And feature of the week number 64 explains how to model individual parameters which fluctuate in time. Estimation of the individual parameters is related to the conditional distribution. It represents the uncertainty of the individual parameter values, taking into account observed data, covariates, and population parameters. This distribution cannot be computed in a closed form, but we can sample it using Markov chain Monte Carlo methods. If you want to know more about this procedure, I recommend you watching feature of the week number 86. In monoliths, there are two tasks that estimate the individual parameters, EBE's task and conditional distribution task. The first task, called empirical Bayes estimates, maximizes the conditional distribution and gives the conditional mode. This is the most probable value of individual parameters. They are used to generate diagnostic plots, such as individual fits, and can be checked in the monoliths interface in the results tab or in the output files. The second task samples the conditional distribution. Each sample represents an individual parameter and their average is the conditional mean, which is displayed in the interface and is written in the output files as for EBEs. The main purpose of sampling the conditional distribution is to increase the diagnostic power of plots and to perform statistical tests. In monoliths, diagnostic plots use several samples for each individual. It allows to circumvent the shrinkage phenomena. In addition, using samples help to obtain unbiased results in the statistical tests. More details about this you can find in these videos. Algorithms used in these two tasks are initialized with the approximation of the individual parameters, which are calculated at no additional computational cost from samples of the conditional distribution during the population parameter task. It gives the approximated conditional mean because the samples come from the conditional distribution during iterations of the smoothing phase of the SAUM algorithm. So when the final population parameters are not yet available. When a parameter does not have random effects, the individual parameters are easy to calculate. They are simply the population values psi pop plus the effect of covariates. This corresponds to both the mode and the mean of the conditional distribution, which in this case is infinitely narrow. Depending on which task have been run, different individual estimates are used in the diagnostic plots. In the display options, there are several possibilities. Conditional mode is available if EBE's task was run and the conditional mean after running the conditional distribution task. If neither of them was performed, then the plots use the approximated conditional mean. By default, Monolix uses the conditional mode for computing predictions, taking the philosophy that the most likely values of the individual parameters are the most suited for computing the most likely predictions. It is a default choice also for observation versus prediction and scatter plot of residuals. Plots from the individual model section and distribution of the residuals plot use by default the set of samples from the conditional distribution. This allows to better represent the distribution of individual parameters and reduce the bias due to, for example, sparse data. Conditional modes and conditional means for each individual, together with their summaries, are displayed in the interface in the individual parameter section in the results tab. Each subtab corresponds to the estimation with different method. In addition, all values are saved in the results folder in a form of text files. In the file called prediction, there are predictions at observation times using approximate conditional mean, conditional mode if the EBE's task was run, and conditional mean if the conditional distribution task was run. In the individual parameters folder, we have several files. The estimated individual parameters file contains estimated values for all individuals. The underscore SAEM is for the approximated conditional mean done during the run of SAEM. The underscore mode is for the EBEs, and the underscore mean is for the conditional mean. The file name simulated individual parameters lists all samples from the conditional distribution that are used for plots and statistical tests. Finally, the files named estimated and simulated random effects contain values of random effects that are calculated when we know the individual and population parameters. The approximated conditional mean serves only for the initialization or to generate plots in case when the EBEs and conditional distribution tasks were not performed. In general, it is not recommended except for a quick diagnosis. The conditional mode and conditional mean are used as individual parameters directly in the model diagnosis. In Monolix, the conditional mode is obtained with the Neldermeth simplex algorithm that maximizes the conditional distribution. As the most likely value, it is used in model prediction plots and in the linearization method for the estimation of the standard errors and likelihood. So it is a good practice to run these tasks if standard errors and likelihood are going to be computed with the linearization option. The conditional mean is calculated during the conditional distribution task when individual parameters are sampled with the Markov chain Monte Carlo procedure. As a result, plots are less affected by the shrinkage phenomena and we can perform statistical tests. This task is also useful when standard errors and likelihood are computed without the linearization method. So now let's look at these algorithms in more detail. The Neldermeth algorithm is an optimization procedure based on a direct search method. If we run a full scenario, that is, we click the button Run in the task section in Monolix interface, with both tasks selected, EBs and conditional distribution, then Monolix first estimates the conditional distribution and then uses the conditional mean as the initial value in the EBs task. This is the reason why we recommend running the full scenario. Otherwise, when we run one task after another, the algorithm starts with the approximate conditional mean. Settings allow to choose the maximal number of iterations and also the tolerance for the difference between two successive iterations at which the algorithm stops. The conditional distribution task samples the conditional distribution, which takes into account the final population parameters estimated by SAM. Monolix uses a Markov chain Monte Carlo class algorithm called Metropolis-Hastings algorithm and initializes it with the approximate conditional mean. The number of samples used for plots is calculated as the minimum between 10 and the value given by this formula called ideal NB. This means that the maximum number of samples is 10, which is usually the case for small datasets. For large datasets, the number may be reduced, but the number of individuals times the number of simulated parameters should be at least 500, and the number of observations times the number of simulated parameters should be at least 5000. This ensures to have sufficiently large but not unnecessarily large number of dots in the plots. The maximum number 10 can be changed in the settings together with other parameters of the procedure. More information about monolics you can find in our online documentation. Thank you for listening and take care.